Hi everyone, my name is Kaylee Cunningham. I'm a PhD student at the University of Florida studying nuclear materials research, and I'm also commonly known as Miss Nuclear Energy on TikTok. Now today, we're gonna go through and debunk The Simpsons. Because unfortunately, some people actually get their science and facts from Homer Simpson.
Nuclear. It's pronounced nuclear.
No, it's not.
Nuclear.
And we are starting off strong here with the pronunciation of the word nuclear.
That should speed things up.
I spent $1,000? Oh well, I'll just tell them that my kid did that. Uh-oh.
So today we're just embracing the actually vibes, because this does not happen in real life, you guys. It just doesn't. Anytime anything goes wrong in a nuclear reactor, we have these long skinny rods, they're called control rods, that drop into the reactor. And they're made of this material that absorbs neutrons and basically just like slows everything down. So this physically cannot happen. Debunked. On to the next clip.
Oh, this is the worst day ever.
Nuclear waste is not green glowing slime. It's just not. It's actually kind of disappointing. It doesn't even glow green. They're little tiny black ceramic fuel pellets that get stacked up inside these long skinny metal rods. That's it. They get bundled together. And they go inside the reactor, they do the fission, and then they come out of the reactor and cool down and go into storage casks. That's it. Debunked.
I think it's full, sir. That's ridiculous. The last tree held 9 drums.
Agent Malone, Environmental Protection Agency. Some Boy Scouts stumbled on your little game of hide the ooze.
Oh boy, where do I start? Okay, first off, nuclear waste, aka used nuclear fuel, aka long skinny metal rods full of little ceramic pellets, would not fit inside the tree trunks. Like, these things are really, really tall and wouldn't fit in these tiny little spaces. Next, used nuclear fuel, once it's all used up and we've decided we're done with it for now, it can be reused, but we won't get into that. What we do first is take the fuel out of the nuclear reactor and put it into a pool to just kind of chill out and cool down. It sits in the pool until all of the neutrons calm down and the fissioning calms down and the temperature cools off. And then we take it out of the pool and put it into what we call dry cask storage. And these dry casks are basically just giant concrete cylinders that are incredibly, incredibly safe to the point where they can withstand a plane crash, a bomb, any sort of awful threat. And we take the fuel and put it inside these dry casks on the nuclear power plant site. And because we have so little nuclear waste, we really aren't in a pinch to try and move it somewhere. It's not like we're running out of space.
Now we just get Shelbyville talk radio.
Which, fun fact, if all of the electricity that you consumed throughout your entire life was generated by nuclear power, all the waste produced from all that electricity that you consumed would fit inside a soda can.
Soda, eh?
But I digress. Our industry does not currently have a more permanent waste storage solution, but the U.S. Department of Energy is actually making a lot of progress towards building that permanent storage solution, what we call a deep geological repository. Now, all that means is that we're gonna bury this nuclear waste inside these dry casks super, super deep underground, and we're gonna put it basically back where it came from, back into the earth. So I hate to be the one to have to break this to you, but no, we are not putting green glowing goo inside trees to turn their limbs into octopus legs and give squirrels laser-powered eyes. If you take anything away from this video, number one, let it be that nuclear energy is probably not what the media is explaining it to be. Number two, do not rely on The Simpsons for scientific information. We love Homer Simpson, but the man is not the brightest bulb. And number three, if you are looking for more actually reliable information, instead of turning on The Simpsons, I recommend checking out the American Nuclear Society's website, ans.org. Thanks, everyone.